What do you reckon the odds are of humans surviving this century? Although it's tempting to feel pessimistic after a glance at the headlines, it's worth remembering that people have been convinced the end is nigh throughout history. But, as you'll have noticed, each time they've been wrong. Take the 1980s, when two academics literally bet on the future of humanity. The first, Paul Ehrlich, argued that the world was sitting on what he called the population bomb. Our growing numbers would soon outstrip resources, leading to famine, social breakdown, even nuclear war. But the second, Julian Simon, was more optimistic, believing new farming techniques and technologies would save the day. When the 10-year deadline on their wager expired, Ehrlich had to pay up. The bomb had failed to detonate. That makes for a happy ending. Or at least it would, if the story ended there. But Ehrlich insisted that the underlying problem remained. And he had a point, then and now. In 1980, the global population was around 4.5 billion. That's due to double by 2037, and hit 10 billion before the century's out. And while Simon was right that innovations would defuse the population bomb, what we know now is that many of them also caused deforestation, degradation of soil and water, and biodiversity loss, making the problems they solved in the short term worse in the long run. As a result, the world faces an existential dilemma. How can we boost production to feed a growing population while reducing agriculture's negative impact on the environment? One solution being explored will sound familiar because it's pitched for almost every problem of modern times: digitization. Smart farming harnesses the power of internet-connected devices to make farms more efficient. From sensors in the ground monitoring moisture and nutrient levels, allowing for precise targeting of water, fertilizer, and pesticides, to self-driving tractors, drones, and robots. As well as making farmland more productive, this should minimize wasted water and pollution from chemicals and CO2. Great news for the environment. The downside is tech is expensive, making this practical only for large farms in economically developed countries. But gradually, smart farming could become the norm. That feels like a step forward, but it only goes so far. Optimizing the current system won't change the imbalance between demand for farmland and the need for wild ecosystems, vital to life on this planet. So perhaps what we need isn't so much a step forward as a step backwards. The ancient practice of agroforestry, in which farmland is combined with woodland, has a lot to offer. Besides providing their own crops, trees offer shelter for both domestic and wild animals, improve soil quality, and store carbon, helping combat climate change. This is more than just an idea. Costa Rica has shown that agroforestry can work, becoming the first country to reverse deforestation. What's more, combining agroforestry with smart farming shows promise, bringing this old idea into the 21st century. Of course, if we're serious about restoring wild ecosystems, the ideal would be to let nature reclaim farmland and regenerate itself. But then, where would we do our farming? Well, how about in cities? This is the idea behind vertical farms, multi-story buildings in the center of town in which vegetables grow all year, protected from the increasingly unpredictable weather caused by global warming. Plus, by adopting aquaponics, which replaces soil with nutrient-rich water, they could even double up as fish farms. Producing food where most of it is needed would cut down on transportation, and by creating sustainable jobs, vertical farms could help rejuvenate cities as well as the natural world. As great as this all sounds, none of these solutions is perfect. Although agroforestry has a long track record, integrating it into intensive modern farms will take time and careful land management. On the other hand, vertical and smart farming are based on new technologies, so they have high initial costs and expose farmers to a new kind of pest: hackers. Agricultural businesses have already been attacked with ransomware, and in the case of large-scale war, food supply chains could be vulnerable to enemy cyber attacks. While these challenges are all at least potentially surmountable, they will require some fresh thinking. But maybe that's exactly what we need. Since it was invented 10,000 years ago, agriculture has been central to human civilization. The world we've built wouldn't be possible without it. And something that foundational can't be retooled without society adapting as well. Right now, everything's to play for. What comes next could be a self-inflicted cataclysm or the start of a better way of doing things. That needn't mean just smart or vertical farming or agroforestry. Rather than putting all our eggs in one basket, we should try all three, plus any others that crop up, until we find a combination that balances nature and nutrition to provide everyone with the healthy, reliable, sustainable food they need.